Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are making video on switch statement. Part 3. So one more part 4 for theoretically. After that we are making video on practical. Okay. So we are discussing more number of programs for better understanding. Okay. Different types of scenarios also we take it for your better understanding. If you have any situation, definitely you can operate very easily for your kindness. So in this video we are discussing about write a Java program to nested switch statement. We are discussing about more than one switch statement. Within the switch statement we are using one more switch statement for understanding. Next one is write a Java program to age problem. I will explain you in detail what is the question here. And the next one is write a Java program to print month if the user enters number of days. We enter number of days, automatically we need to print what are the months respect to that number. Write a Java program to switch statement fall through. This is nothing but if we give one value, the rest of the statements will continuously print without using break statement. How it works will be explained. Okay. So now go through one by one. The first one is write a Java program to nested switch statement. Here what I am doing is very clearly I need to specify. So initially what I am doing is we need to take two values. One is branch. So simply what I am doing is C for Max Physics Chemistry and P for Max Physics Computer Science, S for Max Stat Computer Science. Let us take three parameters. When the user enters C, automatically it is Max Physics Chemistry. Okay, like this it will go. So the second parameter is college year. This is first year or second year or third year is the integer type of data. First one is the character and second one is the integer type. So now what I am doing is switch off college year. If that is 1, case 1, again I need to check switch branch, case is C. So what I am doing is system.out.println first year Max Physics Chemistry. So actually I am trying to make the syllabi. What are the subjects in first year, what are the subjects in second year, like this. But due to time and space constraint, I am dealing only this part. Okay. So again, case P, system.out.println first year Max Physics Computer Science. Similarly, case S, system.out.println first year Max Stat Computer Science. So this switch case is closed. Now I am moving to case 2. Okay, again I am using same things, second year. Again case 3, the branch is sir changed the third year, third year, third year. This is the way nested switch case statement will be used. So in the practical, I will explain you very clear. Clearly I will explain. Okay. So now the next one is write a Java program to ace problem. First of all, I will define the problem, then I will explain in detail. So what I need to say is when the user enters 16, 1 minute, the user enters the age is 16, you are under 16, we need to print you are under 18. If the user enters 18, you are eligible for OAT. You are eligible for OAT. If it is 65 senior citizen, you are senior citizen. So by default what we are printing is invalid ace. Please give the valid ace. Okay, so according to this problem I will explain you switch is case 16, so we need to print you are under 18 break. Similarly case 18 you are eligible for OAT and break. Case 65 you are senior citizen. Other than this, we go for default and we need to print please give valid is. So this is the way we are representing the problem. And the last one is not last one, one more is there. So here write a Java program to print months if the user enters user enters number of days. So we have only four options. One is 30 31 28 and 29. These two, it is February. So for 31, Jan, March, May, July, August, October and December. The rest are April, June, September and November. So when the user have four choices, one is 30, 31, 28, 29, based on this the respective values are printed. So that switch days case 30 November and break similarly case 31 system.out.println Jan March May July August October and December. So the next one is case 28 case 29 February default invalid data. So this is the way we are computing it. So the next one is write a Java program to switch statement fall through. So fall through means without using break how it works. Okay, so initially what we are doing is int n is equal to 20. Okay, so now I am using switch 20 case 10 system.out.println I am printing 10. So no break case 20 system.out.println 20 case 30 so 30 default system.out.println not in 10, 20 or 30. Okay, so when I am giving n is equal to 20, so 20, 30 and not in 10, 20 or 30 with the output it prints. I think you understand very clearly. Okay, in the next video also we are making few more programs that is already we learned in simply for if else statements. Okay, once I am brush up with how those statements are used in switch case also we will discuss. Thank you.